guys, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video I'm going to be showing you my most used apps on my new Galaxy S7 Edge. Before I get into it, I just want to start by saying I cracked my fucking screen and I'm so annoyed. Like, I cracked it in a club and I literally started crying in the club. Everyone's like to me, Mantel, it's only a phone, blah blah blah, but no, it's not only a phone, this is my baby. I mean, the crack's not that, well, you won't be able to see it, but the crack's not that bad, like it's bearable, but this is my baby. And I knew I should have got a screen protector from day one, but I just thought, oh, I've got time, so I just let it hang and hang. I've got one on now just so the crack didn't get any worse, but I knew I should have just got one from day dot. So guys, don't be like me. If you've got a new phone, get a screen protector ASAP, because shit happens. And now look, my screen's cracked. And do you want to know how much they're telling me it will be to get a new screen? £200. Well, £200 to £300 I'm getting quoted. I went, well, I haven't been to Samsung yet, but people have told me in Samsung it's £200. But I thought, oh, let me try the market because it'll be a bit cheaper there. They're telling me £300. It's very expensive to get the screen or whatever, so £300. Guys, I can't deal. At some point, eventually, I am gonna pay the £200 or £300 to get my phone screen fixed, because I've only had this phone for about 4 months. I'm in a 2-year contract. I've still got a long way to go, and this I can't deal with. I can't look at the screen like this. So, yeah, I will be investing that money to get it fixed at some point, but that's no point in the future. Probably next year I'd get it fixed, but for now I'm just gonna have to deal with it. But anyway, let me stop rambling on about the screen. Bit about the phone. Yeah, I'm still loving the phone. I mean, I did get a bit annoyed at the phone, and I was considering getting an iPhone instead, going back to iPhone, and that's just because of Snapchat. Like, I can't deal with how shit the quality on Snapchat can be sometimes. I mean, if you've got decent lighting, like today, I've got good lighting, so I'll get good pictures on there. But if you're in a bad lighting situation, then just forget about it. Like, Snapchat, what is that? Literally, you cannot use Snapchat on this phone in bad lighting, and it just really upsets me. But obviously, the other pros to the phone do outweigh an iPhone by like a trillion, so I'm not just gonna go back to an iPhone for Snapchat, basically. But anyway, as I said, I'm gonna get into it now. So I haven't actually planned this video, I'm just literally gonna show you my most used apps. This is my like most used page on my front screen. I've literally got one page, which is, I've showed you this in my previous video. If you haven't seen it, then I'll leave a link below. But on like my first page, I've just got my Google, so I can quickly search things, and then I've also got the weather and the date and things like that. And then on my second page is my most used apps, and this is the only like two pages I've got, and then everything else will be in my apps folder. So onto this page, I'd say my number one most used app, and I think this is everyone's most used app, is Instagram. So yeah, I love Instagram. I've got an unhealthy obsession. I can scroll for days. I can scroll till I've got a headache, and I know it's really unhealthy, but I just love to do it, guys. So yeah, I love scrolling. These are some of the people that I follow. So that's Zaylee. We've got a few people from work. Maybe I shouldn't do this. They might not want me to show their things. But anyway, moving on to mine. This is my Instagram, so if you don't follow me, then please follow me. My Instagram is MontsXO, and yeah, I'm really trying to work on my theme and stuff, so I'm just kind of obsessed with that at the minute. But yeah, that's my number one most used app. So another app I go on to like every minute of the day is Snapchat. So again, my Snapchat is MontsXO, so if you're not following me, then follow me on there. And yeah, this is just a few people that I've got on my Snapchat. I do love Snapchat. Like, if you've got me on Snapchat, you know I'm always doing some foolishness on Snapchat. But yeah, I love Snapchat. And this is my current one. That's me. So yeah, follow me on Instagram and Snapchat at MontsXO. So they're my main ones for like social media. I am trying to use Twitter more, but I just can't do it. I don't know what's wrong with me. I used to be like a proper Twitter head, but I can't get back into it now. So I'm trying, guys, but I just can't do it. But yeah, so for in terms of social media, then Instagram and Snapchat, and I'd probably say a bit of Facebook are my main ones. So now I'm gonna move on to some other apps that I use like daily. So I've got my SoundCloud app, which I do pay for. I've subscribed to SoundCloud, so I pay $9.99 a month for this, and that's because I wanted to be able to use, oops, don't look at that picture. That's because I wanted to use my Snapchat like offline, and to do that you have to pay the $9.99. So yeah, just get over it. I've worked it out and it's like less than 20p a day, so kind of justifies it, I guess. So yeah, to play music offline you just literally have to kind of add it to your liked folder. Well, that's what I do. And yeah, these are all the songs that I listen to on a daily. So Abracadabra, my boy. At the moment I'm loving UK Grime and then Kodak Black. They're my favourites at the minute. So all of UK Grime, like, they're my niggas. And then Kodak Black, I love you as well. But yeah, so that's my SoundCloud. I'm not gonna give you my SoundCloud address because it's still like user 155. I don't know, like, it's not that deep for me, so you don't have to follow me on there. So now getting on to some things that I know you guys wanna see, all my like editing kind of apps. So I'd say my number one most used app for editing is, well, I've got two apps that I always use in conjunction with each other. I never just use one or the other, I kind of always use both. So the first one is Facetune. So on Facetune, I like to use this to smooth out my skin, and that's all I really do in this app now. Yeah, that's literally, oh no, I whiten in this app as well. Yeah, so I like to use this app to smooth out my skin, and I also like to use this app to whiten the background of my pictures. Yeah, I'm trying to stick within like a white theme, so I like to just white out all the background of all my pictures. And I really like if there's objects in the picture, like say my bed is in the picture, you can white that out as well, and it makes it kind of a grey colour, so it's still in with your theme. If you guys would like to see a more in-depth video on how I'm editing at the minute, because I'm not quite 100% with my editing yet, I'm just still kind of playing around with it, but I kind of like what I'm doing at the minute. So if you guys would like to see what I'm doing at the minute, then just leave me a comment or thumbs up this video and then I'll get that done. So yeah, that's just a bit on Facetune. And then my next favourite one is Snapseed, and I really like this one just to brighten up a picture, add saturation to a picture, and it's really cool because you can actually select different points of the picture where you want it to be a different thing. Like say if I wanted my skin to be more saturated but I didn't want the background to be more saturated, I could literally just click on my skin, as you can see it kind of highlights it, go on to saturation, and then you can change that as much as you want. Obviously I wouldn't do it that much, but I like how you can really select and get right in detail with your editing. So that's like another favourite app of mine. And that's pretty much all the only two apps that I use for like my basic kind of editing. I used to use VSCOcam, but I'm not really that much of a fan of having like heavy filters on my picture anymore. I used to use HBO1 or HBO2. I'm not a fan of that look anymore. I just kind of like a more minimalistic look to my pictures now, and I just like my skin to look popping and the background to look white. That's me. But another most used app of mine, which I am now using like on a daily, and it's just like so unhealthy and I just can't deal, is the Uber app. Uber has my life. I am getting Ubers every day. Like, this is not normal. If you rate your trip, I will rate him a 5 out of 5 because he was very nice. But as I was saying, these are all my trips from the last month or so. Only a month and I've made this many trips on Uber. Like, that is unhealthy. That's really unhealthy. I miss my car so much. I'll let you guys know what happened to my car in another video, but at the minute I'm not driving, and I'm trying this bus thing, but I just can't deal with the bus. The other day on the bus I seen the most horrible sight. I'll leave a picture here. But yeah, that's the type of shit I've seen on the bus, and I'm really not trying to fuck with the bus. So, but yeah, taxis are just getting ridiculous. So I'll soon be back driving, but yeah, for now the Uber's gonna have to do. But as I was saying, I love Uber because you can pay by card, and I literally never have cash on me, so this app's like the perfect taxi service for me, and it's reasonably, like, the service is quite good as well, so can't complain. But yeah, that's eating out all my money. And last but not least, another app that I use like on a daily is my studio app. This app is linked in with YouTube. It's called the Create Studio, and on this you can like reply to comments and just see watch time and likes and stuff, and it's just an easier way to see direct information without actually having to go on the YouTube app. So if you were to get a comment on your video, it'll pop up straight away and you can reply like straight away and you don't have to worry about and you can reply like on the go. So I use this app daily just to reply to you guys' comments. I've replied to all these, so I don't know if it's like that. And then once you've replied, it like grays out, so you can just clear it all off and then you're back to updated. So yeah, I love that app because it just makes life, YouTube life, so much easier. Yeah, so that is it for my top apps that I use. I don't even know how many apps I showed you guys then, but yeah, that's it for my top however many apps that I use on a daily basis. As I said, I'm still loving the phone. I'm like an app junkie. Like, I go onto the app store and I'll just download a shit ton of apps just because they look interesting, and then I'd go through them and I'd probably end up deleting them all. But yeah, I love new apps. If you guys have any cool apps that you think would be useful to me, then please let me know. Also, if you're wondering what my home screen on my phone is, it's a car that I really want. So it's the Polo GTI. Like, I proper want that car. It's like goals. And I believe in the law of attraction, so I believe if you keep looking at something all the time, then you'll get it. So it's my home screen, so I can see it every day and know it's my goal, and then someday I'll just get it. It'll just be there in my driveway and it'll just be mine. So that's the aim of that game. So yeah, thank you so much for watching, guys. We're now in December. Unfortunately, I won't be doing Vlogmas because I work a lot. But yeah, I will be making videos on a regular basis. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I shall see you in my next video. Bye.